Oh, my God, I don't know how many issues of China's book, if they only knew or even less. It's now number two on the New York Times bestseller list.
And there's a good reason for that. It's a hell of a read.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Guadalajara, Mexico, weighing 215 pounds, Ese Rios.
Of course, this weekend, another huge weekend of XFL action, and tomorrow afternoon on TNN, it's the Chicago Enforcers taking on the Las Vegas Outlaws. And then, of course, tomorrow night on UPN in primetime is the Orlando Raids, the only undefeated team left in the XFL, going on the road to take on the Memphis Maniacs.
That's going to be a great game. And, you know, of all the fine-looking cheerleaders that we have, I don't know if Orlando doesn't have the best ones.
I would guarantee you that Orlando has the best cheerleaders.
You almost sound like you have a personal vested interest in that.
Yes.
Be objective. How long have you been here? 2 months now?
I can only hope I make it to three. All right, well, right now it's S.A. Rios and Samoa Joe. Now, of course, getting back to the XFL real quick. What about this whole new, you want to call it a vendetta, a rivalry, whatever you want to call it, between Jesse Ventura and the New York Hitman coach, Rusty Tillman?
Well, you know, Jesse has always been outspoken. That's his career here in the WWF. His governorship in Minnesota.
Hold the phone. Here's a cover. Hook of the leg by S.A. and a kick out.
And I think, you know, Jesse felt that last week, Rusty Tillman kind of chickened out of going for it there for the touchdown and settled for a field goal. Now, Tillman's team won, the Hitmen, so I don't know who's right or wrong.
I know. I thought Jesse had a valid point. At the same time, Rusty, to me, appears like a bitter man. You know, you need to respond.
Yeah, you do need to respond at least, but, you know, Rusty Tillman is, nice move by Samoa Joe out of nowhere. Rusty Tillman has to live with Rusty Tillman's decisions,
right?
Not Jesse the Body Ventura.
True. So, we'll see how this all plays out in the next few weeks. Jesse and Rusty Tillman for the New York Hitman. Well, right now, Samoa Joe is taking it to S.A. Rios. Well, you know, I want to talk about the Radicals as well this week, because there looks like there's some big-time dissension there between Chris Benoit and Eddie Guerrero.
Well, yeah, I think there is, and I'm not too shocked or surprised, because it started at No Way Out, the fatal four-way match for the Intercontinental title. Benoit and Eddie Guerrero go in there with the mindset, as long as one of us wins, we're both winners, essentially.
And it appeared like early on, like they were getting along, which they were.
And they were very successful when they were on the same page.
Mm-hmm.
But then when it came down to it, they both stopped each other from winning the Intercontinental title.
Look out below. S.A. Rios up, over, and down. On to Samoa and Joe, and you can see that both men are feeling the effects of that one. Maybe not so much S.A.
I'll tell you what's on the back of S.A.'s trunks, no destiny. He's not going to have no career if he keeps making moves like that. What makes S.A. Rios tick?
Nice leg drop by S.A. Rios. Here's a cover, hook of the leg, and a kick out just before the count of three. I'll tell you what, we'll have to see what happens between the Radicals, Eddie Guerrero, and Chris Benoit in the coming weeks. But right now, it doesn't look good for all four of those superstars to stay together.
Well, wait a minute. Let's talk about the tag match on Raw last week. Eddie Guerrero and Benoit against Justin Credible and X-Pac. From my vantage point, Eddie Guerrero could have stopped the pinfall on Benoit and chose not to.
I know. That's my point.
And I don't know that I agree with Eddie Guerrero saying, I don't have a selfless bone in my body. I mean, Pitch, let's take you back to Eddie and China.
Oh, wow, what a moonsault. Hook of the leg. And just like that, S.A. Rios victorious here on Jack.
But one thing I'll say for Eddie Guerrero, he's not scared or worried about Chris Benoit.
Not at all. We're